depression and unemployment. This song's for you.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night. Today's a new day, but where are my blue skies? Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
I'll be honest with you,
I almost gave up. A power that I can't explain fell from heaven like a shower. Now,
when I think how much better I'm gonna be when this is over,
I smile. Even though I hurt, see, I smile. I know God is working, so I smile. Even though I've been here for a while,
what you do?
I smile.
Come on and
smile. It's so hard to look up when you've been down. Show. To see you give up now,
God's people.
You look so much better when you smile. So smile.
Now every day ain't gonna be perfect, but it still don't mean today don't have purpose. Come on.
Today's a new day, but there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night.
It ain't easy, bud.
Today's a new day. Tell me, where are my blue skies?
Where is that love, y'all?
Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
The truth is,
I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain.
That Holy Ghost power, y'all.
Fell from heaven like a shower now.
Now I know we've been hurt, y'all, but still,
I smile.
Come on.
Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
Can y'all feel that? You're in right now.
Thank you. may be seated as others are entering at this time. And this is a good time to turn off or mute your cell phones. Good morning. Greetings, students, faculty, staff, guests, and friends. Also, greetings to those watching online. You may access the program streaming from the htu.edu homepage. Today's program is a celebration honoring HT's outstanding students who have excelled academically throughout the 2021-2022 academic year. The men and women being recognized this morning have pushed themselves beyond their comfortable spaces to enter the realm of academic excellence. Through their hard work and perseverance, the students in this room have proven to be true genius generation scholars. The university would like to recognize special guests in attendance. As I call your group, please stand and be recognized. Board of Trustees. Thank you. Parents and family members. Thank you, alumni. Thank you, honorary degree recipients. All right, thank you. Retired HT faculty and staff. Thank you. Elected officials, thank you. Members of the class of 1972 celebrating their 50th year anniversary. Thank you. Other HT anniversary classes? Thank you. And the graduating class of 2022. Thank you. Finally, would all faculty stand and be recognized. Thank you for your teaching. Thank you for your research, and thank you for your service to the community. And now let's give all the honorees and special guests a round of applause. Congratulations to all our honorees. At this time, I would like to invite Ms. Angela Welder to the podium to render the invocation. The program will then proceed as printed.
Good morning. Okay, can everybody please bow their heads for me? Gracious God, we desire your presence here among us as we honor these young women and men today for not only their achievements, but their dedication. We celebrate their capacity for creativity, for critical thinking, and focused effort. We thank you for this moment to gather us as a university, as a family of scholars, and a moment to celebrate what we have been called to do. To teach, to learn, to become one in your world as we prepare ourselves for the mission we call life. Thank you for allowing amazing people to come together and be honored for their gifts, knowledge, and wisdom you have entrusted them with. Enable our scholars to use the wisdom and experience of yesterday as they respond to concerns of tomorrow. Continue to lead our honor students' leaders as they continue to make a difference in the world. We ask for you to be with us as we give our best worship. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I am Elise Barris, and I've had the pleasure to serve as your 2021-2022 SGA Treasurer, Lead Resident Assistant, and Peer Educator for the Counseling and Consultation Center. I am so pleased to be with you this morning and have the honor to introduce our guest speaker, Dr. DeVry Anderson. Dr. Anderson is a veteran of the military and medical professions, currently serving as the Chief Medical Officer of St. David's South Austin Medical Center. Prior to St. David's South, Dr. Anderson served at Carl R. Darnell Army Medical Center. Dr. Anderson was responsible for the clinical skills, sustainment, and training for two graduate medical education and accredited residency and training programs, emergency and family medicine. Previously, Dr. Anderson served as a U.S. Army colonel, and he retired following a distinguished career of service, with assignments that included serving several combat operations. He oversaw the healthcare of thousands of servicemen and women preparing for deployment, those already deployed and those who had suffered injury or illness while serving as members of the U.S. Army. He is a highly decorated veteran and is the recipient of the Bronze Star Medal awarded for valor in combat. Dr. Anderson also helped lead medical operations associated with the U.S. Army's participation in the Hurricane Katrina relief effort. In addition to his military and medical credentials, Dr. Anderson is a West Point graduate, earned a master's degree in business administration from Northridge School of Business in Vermont, and completed graduate studies in strategic leadership at the U.S. Army Command and General Staff College, as well as the executive leadership program at Harvard University School of Public Health. He holds the adjunct professorships in medicine at the F. Edward Herbert School of Medicine, Uniformed Services, University of Health Sciences at Texas A&M, and Health Science Center at College of Medicine. He is also a fellow of the American College of Health Care Services, and a proud member of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated. Truly a fascinating individual who has accomplished so much in his life, it is a pleasure and honor to have Dr. Anderson here with us this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, I give you our honors convocation speaker and distinguished guest, Dr. DeVry Anderson.
At this time, we'll have Mr. Gates bring greetings from the graduating class, and then we'll have our speaker. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Frederick Guess, and it is my honor to welcome everyone to this honors convocation recognizing my peers for the academic achievements during the 2021-2022 school year. We are honoring and acknowledging the hard work and dedication these students have put into their academic and educational studies. Our covenant deans list and honor roll in established HT tradition. As in the words of Nelson Mandela, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. We, the genius generation, are ready to change the world. Thank you.
Please put your hands together one more time for that beautiful choir. Well, good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for that gracious and warm introduction. I give honor and thanks to God by and in and through whose grace I do stand here boldly before you this morning. I'd like to thank Dr. Colette Pierce Burnett and the esteemed Houston Tillotson Board of Trustees for, yes, that's appropriate. Thank you for your courageous leadership, guidance, impact, for your presence. And I thank you for inviting me to speak this morning to the future. And of course, I would never miss an opportunity to thank the truest sister of Zeta Phi Beta, the love of my life, my beautiful wife, the Reverend Dr. Esquire Kiko Anderson. Young man, I just taught you something. You might have missed it. Well, today is a special day, and I consider it a particular honor and a privilege to be here and invited to give this keynote address at the Honors Convocation. Now, as you know, this is a big deal. This is the time where we come together and we highlight the Houston Tillotson graduates who've not only distinguished themselves academically, but who truly excel at the heart of this university's mission, which is to provide opportunities for excellence to diverse populations. Now, we know that the graduates could not, would not, be standing here today without the tangible help of so many people who've supported them along the way. So thank you to all of you who have labored in love alongside all of these graduates, to the faculty and staff, the parents and grandparents and uncles and aunts and cousins, family members, come on. Your support and their academic achievement are without doubt something to be celebrated, and I have no doubt that we will be celebrating collectively as a community many times over in the months and years and decades to come as these young, gifted, and Black graduates live out their journey on the world stage. To be young, gifted, and Black. Oh, what a precious dream. That phrase, which we know was coined by Lorraine Hansberry and set to music by Nina Simone in the late 1960s, it was the spark and the battle cry of a movement. And each graduate represented here today embodies those words. You are, in every way, what our ancestors dreamed of. Academically equipped, culturally aware, and united in your determination to create a better tomorrow. And yet, even as we celebrate and commend the extraordinary accomplishments of these young, gifted, and Black graduates, looking at the world around us, we find a continued and consistent tension. That tension is woven into the fabric of their achievement. For Black or African American professionals, the tension, this underlying dissonance, at times, well, it's obvious, right? At times you can't ignore it, but sometimes it may be more subtle. So this morning, I'd like to consider both the tension and the resolve of what it means to be young, gifted, and Black in America through three distinct lenses. Familiar lenses. Through the lens of faith, through the lens of hope, and through the lens of love. The poem entitled Lift Every Voice and Sing was written by James Weldon Johnson and adopted as the Black National Anthem in 1919 by the NAACP, and we've all sung it many times. It's a powerful and time-honored song of affirmation in African-American communities across the country, and there is a familiar line in the stanza, the first stanza of that song, that encourages all to sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. In that very statement, we see tension. Tension between the darkness of our history and the resolve of our predecessors to overcome that darkness, giving birth to faith. Now, we know that faith is more than just believing a thing. Faith is being so assured of your belief, so confident in your expectation, that your corresponding actions just follow naturally. The Bible teaches us in the book of James that without this follow-on action, our faith is not alive. And our young Black and gifted graduates from times past have taught us through their resolve, in the face of tension, that faith changes things. Young, gifted, and Black honor graduates like Dr. Herman A. Barnett. How many of you have heard of Dr. Barnett? Okay, I see that perhaps some of you haven't. Born in Austin, Texas in 1926, Barnett left Austin for military service in World War II, becoming a gifted pilot and a celebrated member of the Tuskegee Airmen, but he dreamed of becoming a doctor. So after his time in military service, Barnett came back here to Austin and received his undergraduate education at the historically Black Samuel Houston College, which we know just 4 years later merged with Tillotson College to become the Houston-Tillotson University we know today. And like all of you, he graduated with honors. But despite his academic qualifications, because of the color of his skin, Barnett was initially refused admission to medical school at the Texas Medical Branch, or the University of Texas Medical School, which at that time was an all-white school. But he was so determined to become a physician that after applying to multiple other schools, he petitioned the Texas state legislature. He participated in marches and protests, and he even brought together numerous groups and organizations to take legal action against the school for not allowing him to attend. And after multiple hurdles, he was finally allowed to attend the University of Texas Medical School, becoming the institution's first African-American medical student and the first Black graduate from medical school in Texas. But it didn't stop there. After graduating from medical school in 1953, Dr. Barnett completed residency programs in both surgery and anesthesia and went on to become the first African-American to serve on the Texas State Board of Medical Examiners. He eventually returned to serve right here at Houston-Tillotson on the Board of Trustees. Barnett was also a successful businessman. He was the chairman and president of the board of the Northeast Houston Investment Corporation. He was a member of the board of directors of the Lockwood National Bank of Houston, and he was the first African-American elected president of the board of trustees of the Houston Independent School District. Now, I could go on and tell you more about how he was assaulted by police, pistol whipped in the back of a squad car, how he was beaten unconscious twice merely for telling police that he was a doctor and showing them his class ring from UTMB. But if I did, you might miss my point. A point that is so dramatically underscored by the very fact of me speaking to you here today in this medical regalia. Dr. Barnett's actions and the actions of those like him in times of great tension gave rise to an unshakable faith in my generation. A faith that now believes with such certainty that it acts boldly, as if there was no tension. Because Dr. Barnett did it, I don't have to wonder if it's possible. I know it's possible. Now, indeed, some of the tensions that Dr. Barnett faced have resolved. For example, I never truly thought, even for one moment, that I might be assaulted for wearing this gown and this ring at this ceremony today. And people in my generation, for the most part, rarely imagine that they would not be admitted to graduate school simply because they're Black. In fact, in the age of affirmative action, many of the young, gifted, and Black scholars of my day who pursued higher education were criticized and accused of being admitted to the best schools because they were black. But I'm able to stand here before you today, boldly, in Texas, as a physician, because of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Although many things have indeed changed over the past 100 years, the great philosopher George Santayana said it best when he commented that progress consists of more than just change. We must also remember. Those who cannot remember the past are condemned to repeat it. So this morning, we purpose to remember the past accomplishments of young, black, and gifted HBCU graduates of the past to allow us and to allow their example to establish our faith. But we also celebrate the Houston Tillotson Honor graduates sitting with us today through the lens of hope. Despite all of the tensions that we've already overcome, there are still many, many more that remain. The Black National Anthem goes on to remind us that we must also sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. But what is hope? There's a verse in the second stanza of the anthem, and it asks the same rhetorical question, but it asks it this way. Listen. Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the day when hope unborn had died. Yet with a steady beat, have not our weary feet come to the place for which our fathers sighed? Have not our feet come to the place for which our fathers sighed? What are you talking about, Dr. Anderson? What is hope? Where does it come from? And what does it have to do with the young, gifted, and black honor graduates that we've come here to celebrate this morning? Well, can I tell y'all a story? Come on, you know a preacher got to tell you a story. Go back with me to the late 1990s. In the late 1990s, I found myself walking down a warm Philadelphia street in the summer. I can feel it now. I was at the end of my fourth and final year of medical school, and having graduated West Point 4 years prior, I was walking boldly into my future. Come on. I had my white coat on. I had a pager on my hip. I had a purple tie on. My stethoscope around my neck. I see you, dog. If you had asked me then, I would have said without question, without hesitation, yes, I have come to the place for which our fathers cried. So as I was striding confidently down that Philadelphia sidewalk, I saw two black boys, one maybe 7, the other maybe 11 or 12, brothers, I suppose, just two boys playing on the sidewalk in Philadelphia in the sun. And so as I approached, my head was held high, and I overheard them talking. And the younger one said to the other, he said with some excitement, "Look, a black doctor." I was beaming with pride, but only for a moment. Because as I passed them, I heard the older one respond. "That ain't no black doctor, you fool. Doctors ain't black." I paused, and I turned just in time to see the younger one drop his eyes and then drop his head. And I watched his shoulders slump just a little bit as he turned to walk away. Then suddenly, in a moment, I clearly understood that verse in the Black National Anthem that I had heard sung so many times before. Bitter indeed when hope begins to die before it's even born. And I went back quickly, and I knelt, and I talked to those boys, and I let them see my white coat, and I let them touch my stethoscope, and I told them that some doctors were black, and that I would be a doctor in just a few days, and that they could be doctors too if they wanted. What is hope? Hope is different than faith. You see, faith is certain of its belief, but hope thrives in the very presence of doubt. Hope clings to the mere possibility that someday something might be. Hope rises above the tensions and the fears that we all feel when dreaming of the future, but living in the present. And although many of us are deeply engaged in the tensions and the struggles of today, looking at these young, gifted, and Black graduates, I see hope for tomorrow. We all need hope in times of tension, times of conflict, times of war. Because by definition, hope gives us a reason to press on today, even when we're not sure of the outcome tomorrow. Think about it this way. If you know that you know that you know that you and all those you care about and love are assured of the victory, well, you, my friend, are no longer at war. You're at peace. In so many ways, so many of our people are still at war with the racial and cultural tensions that complicate our society, but we use our success and cultivate hope in those who follow in our footsteps. President Barack Obama, our 44th president and perhaps the most prolific African-American leader of our time. Yes. He wrote a book entitled The Audacity of Hope. If you have not read it, I suggest you do. He defined hope this way. He said, hope is not blind optimism. It's not ignoring the enormity of the task ahead or the roadblocks that stand in our path. It's not sitting on the sidelines and shrinking away from a fight. Hope is that thing inside us that insists that despite all evidence to the contrary, that something better awaits us if we have the courage to reach for it, to work for it, to fight for it. Hope is the belief that destiny will not be written for us, but by us, by the men and the women who are not content with the world as it is, but who have the courage to remake the world as it should be. And these young, gifted, and Black honor graduates, as they rise from the dark past by faith, they help us overcome the tensions of today by providing hope. So lastly, we stand with them to embrace the future and the world around us in love. In many ways, the ongoing struggles for social justice and the growing health equity disparities in our communities make us feel like we're at war. And anyone who ever has been to war knows that when you're at war, the only thing you want more than anything else is to not be at war. But Isaiah 2:4 tells us that when love is present, it settles all disputes and brings an end to war. 1 John goes on to tell us that God is love. As a physician and a corporate leader, I can tell all of you young, gifted, and Black graduates that as you leave Houston Tillerson University to pursue career opportunities in science, technology, engineering, mathematics, or maybe even other career paths, you will no doubt be entering institutions, sitting in offices, speaking in boardrooms with far less Black faces than you see in this room today. And while you may or may not be immediately accepted, you will be immediately recognized as a Black doctor, a Black engineer, a Black lawyer, a Black professor, a Black CEO. And so the question I have for the next generation is this. Will we continue to view ourselves as separate, each existing within the collective, but separate from the collective? Or will we one day choose to see ourselves and no longer view ourselves as individuals? To not see ourselves as African Americans or white Americans or Hispanic or Asian Americans, but to see ourselves as Americans, or better yet, to see ourselves as one people. Will we one day view ourselves as one people, unified by our tensions, both drawing from and adding to this collective, made stronger by our diversity, made whole by a shared hope? I believe the author of the Black National Anthem understood this choice that we all have to make, as he ended the poem with this verse, and I will end with it as well. Shadowed beneath thy hand, may we forever stand, true to our God, true to our native land. God bless you, and God bless the graduates of 2022.
Thank you, Dr. Anderson, for those thought-provoking and inspiring words. I present to you again HT's Concert Choir.
I shall not fear the arrow by day, nor shall I fear the terror by night. The God who governs angel armies has set encampments around me. Whom shall I
oh!
has set encampments around me. Whom shall I fear? Oh,
another round of applause for our talented concert choir. We have now come to the highlight of today's program, where we honor our extraordinary scholars. The first group of scholars to be recognized is the W.E.B. Du Bois Honor Scholars. Houston Tillerson University launched its first William Edward Bogart Du Bois Honor Scholars during the 2003-2004 academic year. 9 more students have joined the Du Bois ranks that will graduate tomorrow. Overall, these Du Bois scholars have earned above average scores on standardized tests and were ranked in the top 10 of their high school classes. Du Bois scholars excel in a variety of different academic disciplines, from computer science to psychology. All have proven themselves to be leaders, critical thinkers, and problem solvers within careers such as Dell Technological Services, as a military officer, a Google Team Cloud Software Engineer, website developer and manager, Amazon Web Services Solutions Architect, and establishing setting an international path by traveling to Peru to teach English. These are the examples of our Du Bois scholars. Would all W.E.B. Du Bois Honor Scholars and their staff advisor, Dr. Jennifer Miles, please stand to be recognized. You may be seated. I now ask the W.E.B. Du Bois Honor Scholars, who will be receiving their diplomas tomorrow, to stand as I call your name. Olalikan Adisa, Jordan Anderson Cortez, Dalita Marie Brandt, Tirani Brain, Chrisavion Carpenter, Clay Clayton, Dekisha Lene Frayling, Zaria Touchstone. Congratulations, thank you, you may be seated. Within this educational arena, we have students who have served this great country, and we honor them with the red, white, and blue honor cords. One of our graduating seniors tomorrow, honor student Jordan Alexander Ayub, after graduating, Ensign Ayub will be reporting to the USS Truxton as a division officer, homeported in Norfolk, Virginia. Thank you. We also thank our speaker, Dr. DeVry Anderson, for his service. And now, would all veterans please stand to be recognized? All veterans. Thank you. You may be seated. Now, Greek life is a traditional part of the college experience, and we carry that heritage at Houston Tillerson University. The lifelong commitment to service begins right here on the university campus. in the midst of the service and social activities is scholarship. The HT University, the HT Greek letter organization with the highest grade point average is Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated. The Alpha Kappa Chapter. Would all Alpha Kappa members please stand to be recognized? You may be seated. Thank you. Now we recognize the Dean's List and Honor Roll students. Dean's List. The Dean's List is prepared at the end of each semester. Any full-time student who is enrolled for 12 or more semester hours and who has achieved a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or higher is included on the Dean's List. Students who have an unresolved incomplete grade on the transcript are not eligible. Honor Roll. The Honor Roll is prepared at the end of each semester. Any full-time student who is enrolled for 12 or more semester hours and who has achieved a cumulative grade point average of 3.0 or higher is included on the honor roll. Students who have an unresolved incomplete grade on the transcript are not eligible. Now, I will direct you to page 3 of your program for the beginning of the full listing of the Dean's List and page 4 for the honor roll students. Would all students on the Dean's List please stand to be recognized? Dean's List. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. Would all students on the honor roll please stand to be recognized. Honor roll. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. Now, at HT, we do our best to help our students go through college, and we all know that it takes money to go through college, and so we provide scholarships for our students. Would all students with honor scholarships as listed in the program please stand to be recognized? Honor scholarships. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. At this time, we will recognize the members of our honor societies. Members of the Alpha Phi Sigma Criminal Justice Honor Society with faculty advisor Dr. Lauren Samuels, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. Members of the Delta Mu Delta Business Honor Society and faculty advisor, Dr. Rohan Thompson, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. Members of the Golden Key International Honor Society with faculty advisor, Professor Shawanda Stewart, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Members of the Kappa Delta Pi Education Honor Society with faculty advisor, Dr. Jesse Rivers, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Members of the Pi Gamma Mu Social Sciences Honor Society and faculty advisor, Dr. Michael Hirsch, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Members of the Psi Chi International Psychology Honor Society and faculty advisor, Dr. Deborah Murphy, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Members of the Sigma Tau Delta English Honor Society and faculty advisor, Dr. Julie Hudson, please stand to be recognized. Thank you. Lastly, but not the least, members of the St. David's STEM Scholars and faculty advisors, Dr. Amanda Massino and Dr. Carlos Cervantes, please stand to be recognized. All right, thank you, thank you. Now, at this time, I invite Dr. Rohan Thompson, Dean of the School of Business and Technology, and Dr. Michael Hirsch, Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, to the podium to recognize the top-ranking students. First, Dr. Thompson.
Good morning. I ask all faculty who have imparted their knowledge upon the honorees within the School of Business and Technology to please stand. Thank you, you may be seated. And now the top ranking students, I ask that you hold your applause until the end. As I call your name, please come to the stage to receive your certificate. Master of Business Administration, Jessica Pelache. Delfino Sanchez. Darrell Wayne Williams. Business Administration, Amelia S. Abel. Tamara Deshea Hill. Vanessa Zapata Peters. Computer Science, Olalekan Abdurazak Adisa. And Joshua Gage Lippen. Please give them all a round of applause.
I ask all the faculty who have imparted their knowledge upon the honorees within the College of Arts and Sciences to please stand. You may be seated. Top-ranking students, I ask you to hold your applause till all to the end. As I call your name, please come to the stage and receive your certificate. Biology, Aaliyah N. Albro. Talitha Marie Brandt. Chemistry, Timothy Taylor Bishop. Elvira Wendy Ilbudu. Michaela Shea Martin. Communications, Janice Anisha Walker. Criminal Justice, Christian Morris Brassard. Kaia Rose Dijane Williams. Education, Iman Josea. Tabalia De La Rosa Martinez. Claudia A. Rodriguez. English, Diamond Ingle Moore.
That's my money!
Amisha Onya Pfeiffer. Environmental Studies, Nakaisha Lune Fralin. Kinesiology, Savannah Christina Garza. Tony Martinez. Lamika Renee Turner. Mathematics, Wasim Jamil Ali. Clay Hannah Nicole Clayton. Music, Seth Wesley Aishutz Cowan. Samuel Aaron Peters. Political Science, Jeffrey Lamar Clemens. Kaylee N. Norman. Psychology, Tirani A. Brim. Destiny Angel Eberly. Sierra Elaine Denise Franklin. Brittany Jamika Angelica Gill. Haley Elizabeth Masters. Danny Amara Payne. Sociology, Ariana Naomi Gaines. Ebony Hunt. Associate Degrees of Liberal Arts, Tamika L. Cummings. Jasmina Henry. Sheena K. Luna. Mary Lou Ponce. Let's give them all a round of applause.
Thank you, Dean Thompson, and thank you, Dean Hirsch. I don't think we can appreciate our scholars enough. So another round of applause to our scholars. All honor students may pick up their certificates in the Davidge Durden Student Union building after the program. Today marks the 6th HT Honors Convocation Ceremony for the President and Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Colette Pierce-Burnett. She continues to carve her niche at HT and is making a phenomenal impression on the Central Texas communities. Her awards, accommodations, and accolades from the community are numerous, with such distinctions as the 2021 Austinite of the Year. She has opened the Houston Theological University campus to the entire community, which has resulted in positioning the university in the forefront of the minds of Central Texans. I'm proud to be a member of her team, a team that manages the business of the university at the highest level. We are grateful for her leadership. I present to you our president and CEO, Dr. Colette Pierce-Burnett.
Thank you, Dr. Vanderpoel. I'm determined to get through this without crying. I truly love my students. Can we get all students of Houston Tillis University, the Genius Generation, to please stand? So tomorrow, please remain standing, students. Tomorrow is commencement. Many of you will graduate. But today, we honor academic excellence. And I present to the audience the future. And without a doubt, I know our future is in very good hands with these young scholars, these members of the Genius Generations, and I personally thank you for allowing me to serve you. God bless you. So we're here today to celebrate the achievements of the class of 2022, the honors, one of the largest graduating classes of the in the history of Houston-Tillis University. Students that typify persistence as a superpower. It is my honor to honor these students who represent academic excellence. But before I do, I want to give another thank you to Dr. Colonel DeVry Anderson, and I would like for Kiko, Reverend Dr. Z5B Kiko, to please stand. That is a power couple, and I thank them for sharing this moment with us. And I want to lift a couple things that was in his introduction from Ms. Burris. He's an Army Colonel veteran. He's a doctor. And of all those many accomplishments, the one I'm most proud of is he's a member of the Houston-Tillis University Board of Trustees. And that is a phenomenal thing. So now to honor scholars among scholars. Those earning and maintaining a 4.0 GPA. That's a sign of perfection in academic endeavors. I'd like to celebrate this year's class who exemplify academic excellence and are leaving Houston-Tillis University with that perfect 4.0 grade point average. Please stand as I call your name and remain standing until all scholars are acknowledged for us to individually and collectively celebrate your phenomenal accomplishment. In business administration, Amelia Abel, 4.0. Tamara Hill, 4.0. Vanessa Peters, 4.0. Computer science, Joshua Lipham, 4.0. Education, Iman Josie, 4.0. Tabalia Martinez, 4.0. Claudia Rodriguez, 4.0. Samuel Peters, 4.0. Tierney Brim, 4.0. Sierra Franklin, 4.0. Brittany Gill, 4.0. Haley Masters, 4.0. Tamika Cummings, 4.0. Jasmina Henry, 4.0. Sheena Luna, 4.0. And Mary Lou Ponce, 4.0. Now, if I could, please remain standing, scholars. Now if I could have the families, please remain standing. Now if I could have the families, the members of the tribe, the community of these scholars to please stand. We applaud you all. Thank you very much. So just as we had the family members, members of their communities to stand, thank you, scholars, to stand, we also know that there is a whole support system behind our students to get them to the finish line to help them to be successful. So all staff in this sanctuary, please stand or raise your hand where you are. I'd like to really thank the staff that are behind the scenes, the wind beneath the wings, making this happen. And our scholars definitely do not stand alone in their accomplishments. While our faculty ingrain the love of learning into their students, they continue to pursue their own academic endeavors and professions. So if I could ask all of my faculty to please stand and be recognized. Now for a few closing announcements. I do not have the words to express how grateful I am of the Greater Mount Zion Church for allowing us to be we've outgrown ourselves, for allowing us to be in this beautiful facility and to be a part of our extended family. I thank my friend and support person, Pastor Galen Clark, church staff, and the congregation for your hospitality and your prayers. I would like to give a very special thank you and recognition of a special part of the relationship between Houston Tillotson and Greater Mount Zion. Not only have they invested over $50,000 into our Du Bois Scholars Program with an inaugural honors mentorship program, connecting our scholars with professionals, leading and coordinated by Ms. Denise Sockwell and Mr. and Mrs. Phil and Renee Walker. This affords our students with the opportunity for holistic student development. Members of the Greater Mount Zion congregation engage with our scholars, focusing on increasing career readiness, competencies such as professionalism, oral written communication, and critical thinking. We say at Houston Tillotson quite a bit, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. It's an African proverb. And Greater Mount Zion is definitely a part of our students going farther and going very far. And I personally thank them for that kind of support, because I heard one of your members say that Greater Mount Zion is a greater blessing. So if you could join me in thanking Greater Mount Zion. That's acting, as Colonel Dr. DeVry Anderson said, acting boldly as if there was no tension. So you can talk a good game, but people and individuals and institutions like Greater Mount Zion come to the plate and actually swing a home run in support of our institution, and that's not a small thing. There will be a reception on campus. I encourage everyone to please join us for that. Students, as Dr. Vandepoy said, your honor certificates are available for pickup in the Student Union. The Balfour representative will also be in the Student Union today to take orders for the official Houston Tillotson University ring. I saw the speaker show and flash his ring, so get your ring to flash your Houston Tillotson ring. The Rams Zone will be open Saturday from 8 to 1 for those who are interested in purchasing Houston Tillotson University merchandise. I remind everyone that you can always purchase our merchandise online 24 hours, 7 days a week. And graduates, graduation rehearsal is today at 4 p.m. on the athletic field for all of our graduates, faculty, and staff. Commencement will start promptly at 9 a.m. tomorrow morning. Our commencement speaker is Congresswoman Alma Adams. Congresswoman Dr. Alma Adams. She is the 100th woman elected to the 113th Congress. It's 50 years, in 1972, the Golden Class, Barbara Jordan was awarded an honorary degree. And 50 years later, we have the pleasure of awarding another powerhouse in the Congress, Alma Adams. So please join us in that wonderful moment. Alma Adams was instrumental in facilitating the Fostering Undergraduate Talent by Unlocking Futures Resources for Education, known as Future Act, CARES Act. This act provided funding totaling over $255 million a year for all minority-serving institutions, a specific amount of $85 million to historically black colleges. And we want to thank Congressman Adams for advocating for us to help us to guide through that. I want to thank the Convocations Committee, led by Vice President / General Linda Jackson, who gets us all in spaces and places and makes these kind of things happen for a beautiful honors convocation. Thank you, Ms. Jackson and team. We will close this convocation with the singing of our alma mater, and then please remain standing for the invocation by graduating senior Aaliyah Albro. And we ask that you remain in your seat until the last honoree has exited the sanctuary. And thank you all for being supporters and lovers of historically black colleges and universities. There's nothing like that magic, especially Houston Tillotson. While the choir comes, if I could ask everyone to please stand. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Alea Alvaro. I am a graduating senior. I'm also a resident assistant, a member of Beta Kappa Chi, Golden Key, and also a member here at Greater Mount Zion. So may you please bow your heads as we leave this place. Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the time that we're able to come together on this morning to end out the semester with celebration of all the students and our hard work. This semester was really trying and hard for everyone in different ways, but with your grace and your favor, we're here and we're able to celebrate making it to the end. We come asking that you continue to bless us as students, the professors, as teachers, and all those who play a part in all of the greatness that comes out of HT. Father God, before we depart from this place, I ask that you protect and guide the graduating class of 2022 and that we continue to grow as people and go out and do great things that are pleasing unto you. We ask this in Jesus' name, amen.